Applauding Life After 50 on BCTV is underwritten by White Star Travel Center.
Good morning and welcome to Applauding Life After 50. I'm Sarah Hunter-Lascoskie. I am Associate Director of Marketing and Development with Berks Encore. Hope you're staying warm as we approach winter. It's good to be with you today. My guest today is Jeremy Searfoss. He is the City of Reading Fire Marshal. And today we're going to talk about a topic that is something that for everyone, whether you're young or older, you should be thinking about, you should be remembering. And it's home safety, fire safety, good topics to review, especially this time of year. Thanks for being here with us today.
Oh, thank you for the opportunity. We appreciate the opportunity to get the message out to the seniors to make sure that everyone's safe for the holiday season.
And I know you have a great program that you usually do, Remembering When, and can you just talk about some great tips for folks that they need to remember, statistics, anything that can help people this time of year to stay safe in their own home?
Sure. There's several different things that the Remembering When program covers. Common issues, slips and falls, as well as general fire safety for seniors. So it's important to understand these things and to be cognizant of your abilities and not to overextend yourself, and that's what typically gets people hurt. If they try and do something themselves that they might normally have someone else do, but no one's available, then they end up falling. Those things can all be problematic. So a lot of the injuries that we see on the EMS side or the ambulance side of things, they're all very preventable. Through some education and some safeguards, we believe that these are easily preventable incidents.
Great. And I know you have a presentation that has some great visuals for folks today. If you'd like to show that, just to give people a good idea of things to remember and some of the things you see on a day-to-day basis.
Sure. The first graphic that you'll see here is the fire death rates, and it's done by age. On the left side, you can see under 5. The average range or the average age is 9, but you can see as you move to the right side of the graph, which is in red, 85 and over, the percentage is significantly higher than many of the other age groups. And that can be for a variety of different reasons that we encounter on a regular basis. Sometimes it's a smoke detector issue. Maybe they're not working or they don't have enough in the correct spaces. We always, the code is, and what we require is one in every bedroom and one outside. We always encourage people to sleep with their doors closed. That means that you won't wake up to a smoke-filled bedroom if the fire is in another area of your house. Keep a phone next to your bed. That's a great thing so that if you are in that situation, you can call for help. And that way you can let us know if we need to come get you. But typically those are some of the things that are very important to keep in mind for general fire safety. Make sure that your smoke detectors work. We have a program that we come out, we install 10-year lithium battery smoke detectors all in your house. If you own your home, we'll come out, we do it, it's all free of charge. You just need to contact the fire chief's office or the fire department office, and we'll schedule that, we'll come out, we'll do everything. And those smoke detectors, you don't have to worry about the battery life, they're 10-year lithium batteries. So we've done that in approximately between 60 and 70 homes this year alone.
Wow, that's great. And what's the number if people want to call to have that schedule?
The number to the fire chief's office is 610-655-6080. And that'll get you to our secretary, and you can just ask about what we refer to as Operation Save-A-Life. And then you just need to fill out some information, your name, your address, and then we'll schedule a time. And we'll have a fire truck come out, and they'll go through your house, and they'll put the smoke detectors in.
Oh, wow. That's a great service for folks.
It is. I think it's a great thing in the community. It's funded through our budgetary process, so it's just another thing and another it's just something else that we provide to the community as well as in addition to the service we already do.
Right. And I know you have some other tips for folks in their homes this year.
Sure. One of the things is smoking. Obviously, many fires are caused by smoking or careless smoking. If you think it's out and you're not sure and you just toss it in the wastebasket or you empty your ashtray. So in the graphic, you'll see try and stay outside. You want to use big, sturdy ashtrays, not smaller, flimsy ones or plastic cups or whatever you have laying around. You want something that's going to contain that cigarette and prevent it from falling out or the ashes or anything like that. So you see to wet down the cigarette butts, you can put them in the sand. Some people have those little sand receptacles for them. And never smoke in bed, especially if you're on oxygen. We've had some injuries where that has become a problem. And if you do have questions, you can always reach out to our office and we'd be happy to answer these things for you. That's a big part of what we do is public education and providing answers to questions. But smoking is definitely one of the leading problems that we do see.
What are some of the other problems you see as well for folks, especially in the winter months?
This next graphic is talking about space heaters. You can see we want to keep them at least 3 feet from anything. Generally, you'll see them be very close to people because we want to feel that warmth and that heat. You know, depending on your economic status, maybe you can't run your furnace all the time and you want to have these small heaters. And they are fine. What we recommend is make sure it's 3 feet from anything, whether it's a sofa, a chair, any kind of drapes or anything like that. And also make sure it has what's called a tip-over switch, which means if you do knock it over, it'll shut off. So if it's on carpet, it won't continue to run as it's laying on the carpet, which can be another that can lead to another fire. We'll keep moving along here. If you're in the kitchen, make sure you're wearing appropriate clothing for this. If you wear, you know, whether it's a nightgown or something like that, those tend to be loose. Those are problematic. If you reach across the stove or reach across a heating element, and you have that loose clothing on, that can catch on fire or you can get burned. Use the oven mitts to handle hot pans. Never leave the cooking unattended. That is something that we see here very often. We just had a fire earlier this week. That was a cause of unattended cooking. Nationwide, that's 38% of structure fires are caused by unattended cooking or fires that are related to it. So you don't want to put your stuff on the stove and then go in and sit down. God forbid if you fall asleep, if you're taking medication that makes you drowsy, you want to make sure that's just another point here. You want to be very careful and cognizant of these things. If you are tired and you're hungry, well, you can use the microwave. That's a little bit more time capable and you don't have to wait for something to cook for such a long period of time. This is a stop, drop, and roll. If your clothes do catch on fire, you want to make sure that you can lay on the ground and you're basically smothering the fire. So you want to make sure that you do this. If you run or try and walk, that fire is going to continue to grow. So it's important to be able to smother that. If you are wearing something that you can quickly get off of you and it is burning and then stomp on it, whatever you need to do to put it out, you throw water on it. One of the big things that we always tell people is if you're afraid and you believe the fire is a small fire, make sure that you work your way to get out of the structure and you can call us from your neighbor's house or something like that. The problem is that when people put these things out, that fire continues to grow, and then when we finally do get called, it's a very significant fire versus a smaller fire if they would call us right away. We talked about smoke detectors. I give you the number for that as well. To test those, every time you change your clocks, which just passed a couple weeks ago, check to make sure that they work. You want to make sure that they're in your one on every floor. You want to make sure that they're outside of your bedrooms up as well, but as well as inside of your bedrooms. When you're sleeping at night, this smoke detector is going to make sure that you're safe. We want to make sure that it's going to operate if need be. And practice an escape plan. If you do live alone, you can talk to your neighbors. Generally, we encourage people to communicate with their neighbors so that a lot of times we get very crucial early fire information if someone's home or not from neighbors, because neighbors know them and they know their schedule and what they normally do. Maybe they sleep in, or maybe they're an early riser and they go out to do stuff in the morning and they nap in the afternoon. So all those things are good things to know. And just make sure that you can get to your windows, you can get to your doors, that you have a nice big clear path, that you're not going to trip on anything or slip on a rug or something like that. 911 is the way to get anybody, whether it's a police officer fire department or the ambulance. And we talked about this a little bit earlier, have a phone right next to your bedroom. We encourage people, nowadays they have these, you can wear it as a wristwatch or you can wear it as a pendant around your neck. That goes right to an alarm company. If you need help, then they call us. So anywhere in your home, you don't have to worry about carrying a phone. You would have that service with you, and they call us, and then they send us out right away. And that's becoming more frequent, I think, based on the size of the senior population. So again, we covered this. This is this graphic, as you see on the right-hand side, 85 and above, this is unintentional falls. And again, this comes to if some people are very motivated and they're used to being independent and they might overextend themselves a little bit by trying to be on a ladder or trying to hang something that they wouldn't normally do because no one else is available. So just be mindful and be careful. Don't be afraid to ask for help, or maybe something just needs to wait a day or so till you can get somebody up there that can help you out with that. So you're not at risk and you don't fall and end up having to call the ambulance. Exercise regularly. Again, you want to keep yourself moving. A sedentary lifestyle is not healthy for you. And generally, even if you go outside for a walk, the fresh air, just getting the blood moving and everything like that will help. But obviously talk to your doctor about that for some guidelines. So those are just some of the tips that factor into everyday living, I think, for every age group.
And I think it's interesting thinking about some of these tips that can really help you in an emergency are really day-to-day things. I can think of, especially for fall prevention, people who have maybe a rug that sticks out or a piece of furniture that they'll get to it later. But in emergency situation, that could really impact your ability to get out of your home.
Sure. Everyone functions different in an emergency, and you're moving at such a speed that you're not even conscious of how fast you need to move. So the throw rugs become problematic on different surfaces, or the furniture that sticks out just a little bit further than it maybe it should. So these things can potentially hurt someone and affect their ability to get out of the building if there is a fire. So these are things you want to walk around if you need help with this. Again, we're here to help people with those kind of situations. We can always provide some education and some judgment of what's problematic and what is not. But just, you know, as you walk around your home, you want to look for these things. Oh, do I have enough room to get past this if I really need to move fast? So you want to look at this and you want to determine these things before the emergency occurs.
Right, and a lot of these things have to do with vigilance. I mean, especially for, you know, some people in our audience have probably been in their homes for quite a long time, and maybe they aren't paying attention to the smoke detectors, or maybe they don't have a phone right next to their bed. It's just things that you can always be mindful of that can really help you in an emergency type of situation.
Absolutely. I mean, it's the little things, especially the smoke detectors. The statistics for smoke detectors are very good as far as the protection that they offer. It's a peace of mind issue as long as they're functioning properly. And that's just another tool to make sure that you're going to be safe in your home.
Absolutely. And could you once again just give out the phone number if people have questions or concerns, smoke detector issues, just because I think it's so important to get that number out so people know that you are available in these kinds of situations to make sure people can be safe year-round in their homes.
Absolutely. Our number in the city is 610-655-6080. You can ask for a representative from the Fire Marshal's office. And if you do live outside of the city, you can call that number. If you're not familiar with what municipality or who can help you, we can put you in touch with that person, or we can still offer you some information and some guidance as well.
Great. Any other tips for our viewers at home, both through the holiday season, winter, and beyond, for staying safe in their homes?
One of the things that a lot of people think about is just be mindful of your use of extension cords. Again, another trip hazard. A lot of people will overload outlets around Christmas. Make sure you water your Christmas tree, not just to keep it looking beautiful, but when you hang all kinds of things with electric on them and that Christmas tree starts to dry out, that can be a risk for a fire as well. So usually try and water it every day. You can stick your hands in the holder and make sure that there's enough water in there to keep that tree nice and green.
Yeah, for all of the kind of beauty of Christmas decorations, there are a lot of kind of hidden hazards in those. You mentioned the tree, the extension cords, the lights. You know, people, if they have candles or any other kind of decorations, those are things that, as we mentioned, you just have to be mindful of during the holidays.
Absolutely. You want to make sure that generally people like to leave them on late. I like to try and turn off everything before I go to bed just to make sure that while we're sleeping and you're not absolutely aware of everything, that the risks are minimized, so you don't have everything turned on in your house. We discourage any kind of open flame, any kind of candle. If you knock it over, if it's too close to something, you know, what we really recommend is the LED votive candles. Yes. Or something like that. It gives the same effect, but is much safer.
Yes, and you see those a lot more frequently in stores, and you don't have to worry about yourself or pets or anybody else kind of knocking into something and knocking it over.
Absolutely. It only takes a second for something to happen, whether it's a cat or a dog, or even if you bump into it, and it leads to a small fire, which can be problematic depending on what happens after that.
Absolutely. Thank you for these tips. I know it's a good review for me and for our audience just to know, be aware of your surroundings, be aware of what's going on in your home, and the number one more time for folks if they would like to call.
Sure, 610-655-6080.
Awesome. Thank you so much. We appreciate this. And I just have a couple other announcements from Burke's Encore as we head into the middle of December. The first is our Share the Love event. You might be familiar with, you might have seen the commercials for the Subaru Share the Love event. And Burke's Encore is involved in this as a Meals on Wheels partner organization. If you buy a new Subaru from now until January 3rd, you have the opportunity to donate $250 to a charity of your choosing, and one of those is Meals on Wheels America. So if you're in the market for a new car and you're going to choose a Subaru, we encourage you to choose Meals on Wheels America, because that can increase the amount of funding Burke's Encore receives from the national organization, and that helps us feed seniors in need. There are also a few other ways you can help us share the love with seniors this holiday season. It's our Share the Love Stuff the Trunk / Cooler event at Steve Moyer Subaru in Leesport, at all six of our Burke's Encore centers, and also at a few other participating businesses countywide, including First Priority Bank. You can donate non-perishable food items and toiletry items. Those will all go to seniors in need throughout the county. We know how important it is for seniors to receive our Meals on Wheels each and every weekday, but these packages that we can provide of non-perishable foods can also help us make sure seniors are healthy, happy year-round. So if you'd like to donate an item, please stop by any of those businesses or Burke's Encore Center and drop off something and really make a difference by doing just a small gesture like dropping off an item. So we hope you will help us share the love this holiday season. It's a great program just to make sure the older adults in our community, that we're always thinking about them, making sure people are happy and healthy throughout the holidays. Follow us on Facebook if you're on social media to see the ways in which we're trying to get the word out in the community about this program. Thank you again, Jeremy, for joining us today. Thank you for joining us in the audience. Stay safe and warm this holiday season. Please be advised that Burke's Encore is closed on Monday, December 26th after Christmas. We resume regular business hours on that Tuesday. Again, thanks for joining us. Thank you to White Star Tours for underwriting this program. We will see you next month. We hope you have a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Thank you.
Applauding Life After 50 on BCTV is underwritten by White Star Travel Center.